doing.
This is outrageous. It's unfair.
We would be honored if you would join us.
Hey guys, do you all remember this video that I made a little while ago? Well, to my surprise, it did blow up.
This is outrageous.
And rightfully so, I guess. It's a huge piece that no one noticed in the final cut that we all got in Revenge of the Sith. Now, this video is an addition to that one in why George actually took that part out. It's discussed in the book The Making of Revenge of the Sith, where George discusses the final scene. Now, if you haven't seen that video, go watch it. I'll have it pop up at the end of this one. However, I'm going to briefly reiterate what it was about. It took place at the end of the Mustafar battle, where Anakin bursts into flames, or rather just before. He asks for Obi-Wan to help him, where Obi-Wan refuses and tells him that he loves him, but he cannot help him. Which is true, I mean, he literally killed all the Jedi through Order 66, including younglings. It doesn't really get much worse than that, and I don't see how Obi-Wan could help him. Anyways, George, just before filming, goes up to Ewan McGregor, who plays Obi-Wan, if you don't know, and, well, here's the piece from the book itself. Production moves on to Obi-Wan's new line just before he slices off Anakin's limbs. To prep him, Lucas shows McGregor the edited sequence on one of the monitors. "I cut out Anakin's line. Help me, Master," he explains. "I didn't want him to be redeemed. But the end stays like that," he asks, referring to the sequence as a whole. Yeah. Now, the removal of that line is very important, and that's why I'm making this video. If he hadn't removed it, then Anakin would have forever had the idea of being redeemed, and we could blame Obi-Wan for not choosing to help him, which would have just possibly gone down a very different path. One which I explored in a very different and long two-part fan fiction discussing what if Obi-Wan had saved Anakin at the end of Revenge of the Sith. Now, this is interesting to me in the sense that it closes any possible notion of him ever having second thoughts about the dark side by asking for help. And the fact that it closes any conversation about Obi-Wan now having a full-on chance at saving Anakin. I'm happy George made this decision, because if he didn't, then it would have looked like Anakin actually regretted what he did, and which he did when he was crying, we can see that, and George actually even says that in the deleted scenes too. However, now, in this scene, after losing to Obi-Wan like that, it just feels out of character for Anakin to ask for forgiveness and to be helped by Obi-Wan. At this moment, he is engulfed in rage, and that's what keeps him alive. So I think it's very true to Anakin's character and Darth Vader's character as a whole after his completed transformation once he lost to Obi-Wan. I thought it'd be cool to show George's final words on not wanting Anakin to be redeemed and explaining them a little bit in my theories and thoughts. So let me know, do you think Anakin's line should have been left in there, or are you happy George took it out? Thanks for watching, everyone. Have an awesome rest of your day, and I will see you all in the next episode of Star Wars Theory. Until then, my fellow Jedi and Sith friends, remember, the Force will be with you always.
Fulfill your destiny.